Good morning, Nigeria. Today is the 14th of June, 2019. And as you can see behind me, we are standing right at the newspaper stand at the popular Ogba Junction.
Yes, personally, I have my reservations. An institution like INEC should not be telling Nigerians that they don't have a server. It's a very big shame on their own side.
Well, first and foremost, we have to look at, if the INEC say they don't have a server, the card readers, all those fingerprints, where does it go to? That's number one first question we need to ask.
So then I laugh. Is it that INEC is taking Nigeria for a ride? Or do INEC think that all of us, you and I, and the other 200 million Nigerians were fools? This is the same INEC that was saying they have a server. They came and posted a server only for you to go to court. You are telling us you don't have a server again. What kind of system is that? What it means is simply that something was fundamentally wrong in this 2019 election.
I'm looking at it from this angle. Our judiciary should come out and look at this thing holistically and tell the Nigerian the truth.
Okay, I commend the president, Madam Muhammadu Buhari, for that courage to declare June 12 as Democracy Day.
Today we know it's May 29, and we expected the president to make a speech on how he's going to correct so many things that have gone wrong in his 4 years rule, and what he intends to do to move Nigeria forward. He never did that.
You heard the president made a speech in June 12. He said he's going to take away 100 million Nigerians of poverty. And you look at if you look at the newspaper today, they batch an opposition party for not talking about the speech. You are going to remove 100 million Nigerians from poverty in 10 years. Look at 10 years. How many years is he going to spend? What are the steps is he going to take? He's not revealing it to Nigeria.
You and I know very well that the security agencies are not doing enough. I'm talking about the whole security agencies, starting from the Nigerian police, who actually have the statutory right to provide crime and other criminality in the country. But like they have been overwhelmed with what is happening. And the military, talking about the military itself, the armed forces, you know, they are not also doing enough. But it is not to say that they do not have the capacity to bring all this killing and banditry to a stop. But you see, in every given situation, there's somebody who gives another. My belief, personal belief, is that the commander-in-chief has not given that firm order to his security chiefs to go after all these bandits and all these kidnappers and all these criminals, you know, to rob them out of this country.
Oh,